guy towards the left in the green shirt, his name is Eric Reeder, and he was like the leader. It's kind of funny because Eric Reeder, leader, they're mine. Okay, this is a map of Nicaragua, and we went into the capital, into Managua, into the village of Dios Provee, which means God provides. Okay. A few things that I noticed were that the speed limit is in kilometers, which that's kind of weird because it's not here. Also, that 28 Cordobas, which is their units of dollars, equals one US dollar, which that really blew my mind because that's a lot. Their headlights aren't really like yellow, they flash different colors, like purple and green and blue and red, which I thought that was kind of weird. So I really get like distracted, like, whoa, that's super cool. So good thing I can't drive in Nicaragua. There's really like trash everywhere, even in the villages, on the side of the road, anywhere that there's grass, like, you can't take like two steps without there being trash, which is really sad because it's really, really pretty there, like really beautiful. Okay, this is some of the food we ate. The top left picture is kind of cut off, but it's basically like graham crackers, but really, really thin. And then you can kind of see like the Powerade bottle, how it's indifferent, but they do have Powerade there. But it doesn't taste the same, it's really a lot sweeter. And then below that, we ate some fish, some mashed potatoes with like cheese. They chopped up some vegetables, but the carrots, they're like this big. They're really, really big. On the top right, those are some banana chips. On the last day, we got to go eat out at a restaurant, and those banana chips are really good. They just taste like regular chips, which is weird because they're banana. Okay, and then this picture is kind of cut off, but we ate a pancake for lunch with beans and rice, which we had with everything, and a little pico de gallo, which was really good, and some little like sausages, and some fruit, and the one in the middle is a pineapple. Their pineapple is white. Everything is sweeter down there. So this first picture right here is a picture of their $100 bill. 100 Cordobas, which equals $3.51. So if you had $100 down there, you would only have like $3.02 here. And then the other one was like a picture of a $50 bill, which you would only have like $1.78. Like that really, really blows my mind. This is like a picture that I took when I was riding the bus because that's how we got everywhere, like we rode school buses. And there's just trash everywhere. I don't know if you can see it because it's kind of hard to see. But like all of that kind of looks like white stuff, all that is trash. Okay, this is like, since we're in Managua, which is the capital, this is their White House. This is like where their government and everything takes place. Okay, so the picture on the far left is people driving. Do you see like the white line and how there's like a white car and a black car? It's like two lines, but everyone just kind of does what they want. Even though the speed limit is like 30, everyone goes like 60. And you can drive on either side, you can drive on the road. That's a really scary experience. Okay, and then the middle picture, do you see like the tree in the back? Like the president, his name is Daniel, and this is what it has to do with his wife. She's really into witchcraft, and these trees are like some type of witchcraft. But when you're down there, you're not really supposed to talk about Daniel, and like every light post has Daniel like graffiti on it, so everything is his and you're not supposed to talk about it. Okay. Okay, this is a stop sign, which I think is cool, and how it has like an arrow that says double via, which means like both ways, and I think that's super cool that they have a stoplight, because we have stoplights here and stop signs, but it's not enough just to put a stoplight. They have to put a stoplight and a stop sign because people are really reckless drivers. Okay, this first picture, it's really hard to see, but right above like the weed is a volcano. From the plane, we were driving over Nicaragua and there were like a lot of volcanoes, and I thought that was really cool that you can just like look out your window and take a picture because you don't see a volcano every day. And in this other picture, we went to a volcano called Messiah, and this is the first time that they had lava in like 200 years that you could actually see it in the daytime. And just like last month, in the middle of July, people went down there and like tested the lava in their like spacesuits, and I was like, whoa, that's cool, I fit in here. This is like the gate at the Project Hope mission base. Like, they have to open the gate, like it locks, and then there's barbed wire fence and you can't climb over it, so we were super safe. Okay, we went through Project Hope, and we got like a shirt, and it says, love knows no borders, and that's kind of what their theme is. And they go into like a lot of different countries and just like minister to the people. Okay, when we first got there, into like the village, all the people were there in like the community center, and when we walked in, they were just clapping for us. They didn't even know us, nothing. And they were just clapping for us, and I thought, wow, like, that's all I could think of, was like, how cool is that they're clapping for us? Okay, I'm feeling the pressure since my Spanish teacher is here. Okay, but it says, welcome North Americans to Nicaragua, to the village of Dios Provee, which is God provides, and where God is in control. This is a picture of a house, because like what we built. This one is painted and we didn't do a lot of paint, but their houses are the size of my room, and they fit like 10 people living in there. Plus they have like plastic chairs, and then they hang up hammocks, and that's their house. Yeah, they don't have a kitchen or anything. Like in the back, they have like kind of like a tote with water, and they just use it for everything. Like they have like little sippy cups, and the babies just drink out of it, and then they'll go in there and wash their hands, and it's really like monkey water. They just go to the bathroom like in the corner. They have like a little... No, it's kind of like, it's really hard to explain. Like they have a corner like where the fence is set up, but then they have like some boards that enclose it, and they just have like a shower there, and then they kind of just go to the bathroom there in the hole in the ground. It's outside. Okay, so everyone is designated a family to kind of hang out with and have a relationship with, and this is my family, but I shared it with Michelle and Dwayne Johnson because it was a really big family. Most people have like two or three people in their family, we have like seven or eight, but not everyone here is Michelle. Okay, so the girl in the green shirt, her name is Margarita, and she's 17. The girl in the striped shirt, her name is My Lady, but it was really funny because the guy in the gray shirt, Erling, I was talking to him and I was like, oh, who is this? In Spanish, of course. And he was like, My Lady. And I was like, oh, that's your girlfriend? He goes, no, my family. And he was like pointing to his name, trying to explain that it's not his lady, that's her name. And then Erling, of course, was the guy in the green shirt. Gray shirt, and the lady, the second lady in the striped shirt, she's the grandma. Everyone just called her mom. And then the boy in the middle in the green shirt, his name is Levy, and he's 8. The boy to the right of Levy, his name was like, we were building the house. And then the little boy to the left, they just called him Jay. That was his name, Jay. And then his name was like Veneer. Okay, this was their house. We were kind of building it. They just had like this any tiny bed, like just like a bed frame, but they didn't really have a bed. They just like put a sheet over it. And that was Sabrina, and she was mom's granddaughter because all of their parents were at work, so they all just hung out with her. Okay, this is Levy. He was my little buddy. Like everywhere I went, he went. We would like hold hands and skip, and he loved to like play with my hair, so I'd give him piggyback rides, and he would just play with my hair the whole time. Okay, so we went to the dump and the feeding station at the dump, and this is Lola, and she's like the guard animal because they don't really have a lot of dogs. Dogs are hard to feed, and birds eat less. This is like the gate into the feeding place at the dump. They have like cactuses and stuff, so like, well, a few animals that they have, and people don't come in. And I couldn't really take pictures of the feeding station because there were gang members across the street like watching our every move. And it took them 2 years to be able to set up the dump there because of the gang members. They used to have like police escorts, so you have to be like really careful what you do, and you can't leave the gate because it's not a safe area. But this isn't in Dios Probe. We went to a different village. Like, 4 or 5 girls only went. Okay, these are just a couple of pictures of how like pretty it is. There's some like mountains in the back. It's just really pretty. Okay, this is me and Dominga. We went to the orphanage. It's called Bluebird Orphanage. And it's not a real, like, what you think an orphanage would be like. It's an orphanage for mentally and physically handicapped kids and adults. And we went there as I wanted to play with the kids. I call them kids, but they're kids and adults. And they go there either because their parents can't, like, afford them or because they get, like, a better life there. And some parents do come and visit them. But we just went there and danced with them and played with them and painted their nails and we pushed them in the swings. Those are like what they call the older kids, and they like stayed outside, but then you would like go into this little building, and it was really sad because, sorry, there were like all these babies like on beanbags, and this one where he had like 3 legs and his body was twisted, and then they were like other kids who couldn't walk, and then you went to the end, and there was like this one little baby, but she wasn't a baby, she was 4 years old, and she was like this big. And she just had like a growing disorder. But Sherry Allen, she went to talk to the baby, she like bent down, and she's like, hi baby, how are you? And the baby started going like, oh, like trying to talk to her, and that was really sad, because there was also like other kids sitting down on the ground, and they were just smiling and clapping, and it was really overbearing, and I had to walk out. Okay, also, okay, yeah, this is how dirty it was. Like, that's just like my sock tan line from all the dirt, and I had socks on and tennis shoes, and it was really, really dirty. But on the other side was the House of Hope, which is like a house where girls who are prostitutes go because prostitution is legal in Nicaragua. And so we sat there at the table and we colored with them and we kind of talked to them, and I was like, I would point to them and they're like 4 or 5 sitting at my table, and I was like, how old are you? And they're like 15. I'm like, how old are you? She's like 17. I'm like, how old are you? She's like 21. And the 21-year-old had like a 2-year-old baby going over to play. And since prostitution is legal, if their family can't pay, they just say, here's my daughter, you can have her. And so like, that's the way to get around it, because the daughter works for the people. She can like clean their house, but then they're just there, so then they have to become like in the prostitution business. And also the girls at the dump, they make bracelets, which I thought was really cool. Because the girls who make bracelets are like the breadwinners of their family. because their parents, they just go to the dump every day. But to be able to make the bracelets, they have to figure out an exchange with their parents that they can go to school for half a day and then make a bracelet for half a day so they can make an income for their parents. Okay, on the top left is a minion pinata. And this is for the boys only at VBS. Every day we have VBS at the community center at 2 o'clock. They call us gringos, which means kind of like white people. They'd be like, oh, gringo, gringo! But we had to open the pinata. We just like hit it once with a bat, and all this candy fell out, like Nicaragua candy. And I kid you not, it was gone in 2 seconds. Like, it's like nothing you've ever seen before. And the cat one is for the girls, the same thing. And the bottom picture is like my family, we did crafts. Every day we made a crown. And we had 2 crowns and I put them on the kids. And I was like, oh, you're so pretty, you're so beautiful, you're so nice. And then they just put it on my head and they're like, no, you are. Thank you for coming here. It was kind of like a very humble moment. Okay, every morning we had a daily devotion. Michelle in the green, she led it, and then Tanya in the blue shirt, she translated it. And I'm in the yellow shirt, and there's my buddy Lovey just chilling out on my lap. Okay, this is me in the market. On the last day, we went to the market, and we got to try a smoothie. And I tried, like, these little green fruits. I was like, can I try one before I eat it? Like, before I put it in my smoothie? And, oh man, it was gross. But then you can just pick, like, any few fruits you want, and you can just whip up a smoothie for you. So I was like, ooh, I'll try that. Then we went to an old volcano, but now it's, like, filled with water, and we got to swim there. And you can't really go out past this, like, little dock in the middle because it gets really deep because in the middle of the water, it's 600 feet deep, so, and there's no lifeguard, so if you were to drown, then you're gone. And it was called, like, La Abuela, which means the grandmother. I think it's really cool that they have like graffiti there. Okay, not cool that they had graffiti, but that their graffiti, like they know what cars were. And they're really good artists. In the village, a couple of them have TVs, so they try to like play matchmaker. And they'll like point to you, they'll be like, okay, you're Shrek and you're Fiona. And that's how they would make matches. Okay, here we are, we've got like suitcases. And we're giving stuff to our family. I was giving them like deodorant, and then Levy has like a headlamp on that you push the button, and they were all just like so fascinating. And they really like headbands, like once I showed them what it was, I'm like, wow! And they're just like so thankful that we gave them like the basic necessities, like deodorant, soap, toothpaste, toothbrushes. This is when we were leaving, like everyone came because we were. This is the last day that we would see everyone. Okay, this is me and Randy. She also came. She was like having a tough time in her life before she came, and then she came to Nicaragua, she found out, saw how God really opened up her eyes. And then this is Bella, and she was like, she was a translator, but we were friends because I could speak a little Spanish and she could speak a little English. And I kind of just know like the friends that I made on this trip, they're not going to like go away in 2 days. They're going to be there for me forever, like friendship wise. Okay, this is my family when we were on the bus, we were meeting. We were kind of just like sad to see them leave. And the little girl, Natalie, she's being held by my lady, that's her mom. She didn't want anybody to hold her. She didn't like anything but her mom's picture. She's like reaching out to us, like, no, don't leave. Okay, the whole time, like thinking about the mission trip, like I was thinking about Matthew 28:19. It's like, go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And that's what we did. We went to Nicaragua to build houses, but in reality, it was to build relationships. Okay, does anyone have any questions?